You've learned what Azure SQL Edge is. In this video, you'll dive deeper into the various architectures and use cases that customers are using Azure SQL Edge for in this video of Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. I'm joined again by Vasia, a program manager on the Azure SQL SQL Server team. Thanks for coming back on the show with us.
Thank you for having me here, Anna.
And on the previous video, we talked about what is Azure SQL Edge. So if you haven't seen that video already, we'll put a link to it in our description. You should definitely go check it out. Now, in this video, we're going to dive a little bit deeper into some of the IoT reference architectures related specifically to Azure SQL Edge and even a customer use case. So, Vasia, why don't you tell us a little bit about some of the architecture possibilities with Azure SQL Edge?
Sure. As we all know that there are millions of messages that are being generated by the IoT devices, especially from the sensors installed on these devices. And by devices, it could be anything. It could be retail stores, smart factories, automobiles, et cetera, et cetera. So if you look at the architecture here, you will realize that the goal of Azure SQL Edge on a whole is to collect all this data that's coming from these sensors and to analyze this data. As we already know, Azure SQL Edge is a containerized application which runs on the same SQL engine that powers the SQL Server and various other Azure SQL offerings. The streaming engine that you see here is the Azure Stream Analytics, which helps us with many tasks such as windowing, transformation, anomaly detection, aggregation, and all these play a key role in Azure SQL Edge's time series capabilities. The trained ML models that are deployed to the Azure SQL Edge instance will monitor functioning of components in either a connected or a disconnected scenario. And for the purpose of this example, we are looking at a connected scenario. Finally, data after processing, analyzing can actually be moved to the cloud. And in the case of a connected scenario, this happens through the IoT hub. And the reason why we move data to the cloud is for long-term storage and for further processing. From storage services, data can also be sent to machine learning, Azure Machine Learning, for retraining of the models. These updated models can then be sent back to Azure SQL Edge to improve ML performance for the IoT applications. So, and the other thing that you can see is from these storage devices, business analysts can use Power BI to analyze the warehouse data. And also finally, web, mobile, and other applications can be built on the serving layer as well. For this, you can expose APIs based on the storage data for third-party uses.
Awesome. This is really cool. And what I think is most powerful here is that we've taken a lot of the technologies that you kind of saw on the left side and moved them from being cloud only to being able to be actually used at the edge. Like things like cognitive services and Azure ML were not things previously that you could really run at the edge. So that's really cool. What about customers? Do we have some customers that are already implementing with Azure SQL Edge?
Yes, we do have a couple of customers that are already using Azure SQL Edge to solve a lot of their business challenges. And I would actually want to talk about one such customer, Fugro. So Fugro is a geo-intelligence provider. They help clients in the energy sector gain vital insights, especially for marine projects. So to support its clients in early project phases, Fugro sends a team of oceanographers, meteorologists, et cetera, to collect environmental data such as water depth, wind currents, waves, temperature. So this data, which is collected on ships through sensors, is then stored on the ships. And until recently, the marine data that Fugro collected offshore was made available via a satellite link to the company offices that are on dry land. So this data acquired over the satellite was then imported into Microsoft SQL Server on premises. And then the Fugro team would run analytics on this collected data to derive insights for the customers. So one would say end-to-end, this entire process took on an average 2 weeks from collecting data to finally giving insights to customers. And this was not ideal for Fugro. So there are multiple challenges that this company faced. One, they were not able to run real-time insights. Most of the analytics happened only after the ship had reached the coast. And during this entire store exploration process, the ship had to store hundreds of GBs of data, which is not a cheap affair. It's very expensive to store that much data. So the company actually set about to fix these problems. And this is what you see here in terms of their architecture. As we discussed initially, they were all on SQL Server premises. And what they did was they actually moved the data into Azure SQL database. And that was the first step towards moving into the cloud. Then they also wanted to use the network edge. And for that, they deployed Azure SQL Database Edge on various ships and buoys that they use on their unmanned vessels and things for collecting the data. Then through this process in which they are the team actually devised a new process in which Azure IoT Edge and Azure SQL Edge were deployed locally at the offshore project site. And at this time, they actually used unmanned vessels. They didn't want to send their oceanographers over there because they believe that they are actually trained models on Azure SQL Edge, which will collect the right data from them. So owing to this Azure SQL Edge, the team was able to ingest, query, store, and also process time series data locally, thereby saving the company significant time. And from what the company told us, they now get data within 8 minutes. That's actually from 2 weeks to 8 minutes. And there were a lot of cost benefits associated with latency and bandwidth usage. So this is one of our customers who's currently using Azure SQL Edge.
Wow, that's a lot. I mean, just that 2 weeks to 8 minutes, if you think about how much faster you can, you know, innovate and make decisions when you're getting data, you know, getting reports in much faster fashion. Thanks for sharing that with us. You know, we talked about this very specific use case and we talked about kind of the general architecture. What about other scenarios? What other scenarios is IoT and things like Azure SQL Edge good for?
So when you look at sample use cases for Azure SQL Edge, it's not restricted to a particular industry or a particular segment of manufacturing or anything. It actually is pervasive. It's everywhere. That's what when I initially said that IoT devices are all around us, which means data is constantly being generated. Some examples, but not limiting to this, are manufacturing, smart factories. When you look at manufacturing, the fact that factories are located in places where you might not always have internet connection to send and process data. So you need local processing as and when needed. Defense, another key place, oil and gas, automotive. Automotive one need not talk more about automotive, given the fact that we have autonomous vehicles, driverless vehicles, the number of data points one has to collect, the sensors that are put on these vehicles. Healthcare, the current situation with COVID and all those things, having Edge do most of the work for healthcare purposes, that's super important. Factories which are providing for these healthcare officials, retail, finance, aerospace, smart buildings and homes. These are just a few of the cases that we kind of thought about, but it doesn't stop over here. Azure SQL Edge is there wherever IoT is. In short, I would like to say Azure SQL Edge is not just limited to the use cases that are shown here. Azure SQL Edge is there wherever IoT use cases exist.
Awesome. Thanks, Vicia. You know, that's really powerful. And I really like what you said there. I like how you showed us these different use cases and industries, but I think you make a really valid point that we're not really tied to a specific industry. And as time goes on and we become more of a digital type of world, which I think that's the direction we're actually already in, this is going to be really important. So thanks so much for sharing that with us today. This is part of a series, so we do have one more video where Vasia is going to go into an actual demo and show us how this thing works. So be sure to tune in for our next episode. But in the meantime, please like our video if you liked the video, subscribe to our channel, leave us a comment, and we'll see you next time in Data Exposed.